Hey everybody, welcome to Redbird Gardening and Design. I'm Anissa. The other day I was driving around and I saw a gentleman who had a tree in the back of his pickup truck. It didn't go well. I'm going to show you some pictures that will help you understand what not to do in regards to that. Trees cannot be transported upright. I have dirty fingers, I was in the garden. Reason being, their big issue is called wind whipping. Now, wind whipping is when, as it sounds, right? Like wind and it's being pushed around. That's right. So I'll show you with this plant over here. Okay, this ligustrum is in fact, it was a peach tree that was in the back of this guy's truck and it had peaches on it, about the size of an MLB baseball. And the wind is going to pound the snot out of that plant like this. See it whipping around like it just, right? That's what happens to the tree. Not good. A plant, unless it's a palm tree, isn't built to handle whipping like this in the back of a truck. So what's gonna happen to that fruit? It's all gonna fall off. Hopefully he hasn't damaged, I didn't stick around to see the end results, but hopefully he did not damage the plant itself. So when a peach attached to the plant, there's a teeny little stem. And the weight of a peach is heavy. So when you bite into that amazing fresh peach first time in usually June, July, August, it's juicy, it's running down your arms, it's so good. It's full of water, which is heavy. Probably going to fall off. Hopefully that's all that happens. Or it will not let go because it's still green and that stem will rip the attached portion to the tree itself. So you could have extreme damage to your fruit tree. So you're all probably wondering, well, how do I get a fruit tree from the store or a nursery home? Well, here's some pictures to show you some ideas. And I know it's not gonna be readily available for everybody as far as costs go, right? A fruit tree, a good fruit tree that's been grafted properly, takes a long time in the nursery. Here's a chart that will show you what it takes time-wise for the nursery to create that tree. So like the graph is showing you, 2 and 3 years old tree that you're getting to plant in your yard, which is usually what most people have, caliper, which means the circumference, how thick the base of that tree is, you want it to be 2, 3, or more inches wide, the circumference. Because that tells you that tree's several years old, 3, 4, maybe 5, depending on the tree itself. And that way it's gonna get a good start. So this is all that is attaching this peach to this plant. And the tree this gentleman had was probably 6 to 8 feet tall. So I'll say his branching was probably double of what these are, maybe. And he had very sizable fruit on the tree. So what can happen is, this attachment here, hopefully the peach will just fall off and the branch will be fine. Because you don't want to lose a branch, right? That's potential fruit production. So it could not let go and tear into this line, or even more so, if you have a lot of fruit, like on this branch does, it'll come back and break or rip, and then you've got a tear that can run down the main trunk of the plant. That's a disaster. So that's what not to do. So if you're going to transport peach trees or any fruit tree and bring it home in your own pickup truck, lay it down. Because like I said, wind whipping can destroy your plant. You'll get it home and it won't grow. It'll be in shock. You've broken branches, and what you put $200 or more investment into that plant has now been fried. Wind whipping is a really rough situation for plants to go through. So lay them down. All you have to do is tip them side on their side, gently. I like to prop them up a little bit if I can, so they're not crushing the lower, the bottom branches aren't getting crushed in the truck or the bed. So if you could put, I don't know, some blocks of wood or something where you're gonna lay it down, it takes a little bit of planting, so they're slightly upright, and put a towel down underneath it too. That'll help with cushioning the weight of the tree onto those branches. Also, if you've driven on the highway in Florida, you'll see transporting palm trees, and they stack them on a flatbed truck on a 45 like this, one onto the other, but they're also braced so that they won't crush each other. The thing I want to point out is, if you've noticed, they'll put a netting over the fronds or the leaves of the tree, or a tarpet, so that they don't get wind whipped. So that's how to transport fruit trees home, or any tree at all. Don't put them upright in the back end of your pickup truck. You will destroy the tree, you will damage the tree. Don't forget, you put some investment into it, take good care of it from the get-go, and you'll be successful. And now, you know.